We guess most of you have watched a horror movie before or come across a very scary looking person in the night and said later in the figurative sense, "I was scared to death." None of you have literally been scared to death, unless you're watching this show from beyond the grave. But imagine something happened to you that was so scary it was unimaginable. Could that experience frighten you to the extent you just died on the spot? Do you think that sounds silly? Well, let's see if it's possible. First of all, you'll likely know why we get scared in the first place. Let's say you turn a corner while walking down the street and you're suddenly faced by a huge dog who's snarling and ready to pounce on you. Unless you're inhuman or one in a million, it's likely your heart will beat faster and you'll breathe faster. What you're feeling is what a person might have felt 100,000 years ago when faced with a saber-toothed tiger. This is a natural reaction that we sometimes call fight or flight. Do you stay and fight or do you go? What's happening to that person is that part of the brain called the amygdala is activated. It's the region responsible for fear. The amygdala then sends a message to other parts of the brain, and one is called the hypothalamus. This region of the brain triggers the release of hormones such as adrenaline. This can be called an adrenaline rush. When your body produces this stuff, your heart beats faster, and more of your blood goes into your muscles and brain. You're alert and can react faster to whatever danger is in front of you. If you didn't experience this and you didn't ever get scared, you'd likely only be on this planet for a short time. This is of course good news for us in some situations. It's kind of a survival mechanism. But being scared to death, well, surely that wouldn't make any sense at all. You may as well have gone toe-to-toe with a tiger rather than just fallen to the ground and served yourself up as a ready-made meal. But you know what? You can indeed be scared to death. Let's first explain why and then look at some examples. It boils down to something called the autonomic nervous system, which basically means stuff that happens to you unconsciously. There are just some things your body does that you don't really control. One of them is your response to fear. When it comes to fear, sometimes a person can kinda have an overload in terms of the bodily response. Too much adrenaline, too fast a heart rate, and boom, a person might just drop. What most people don't know is that adrenaline can be a killer. While it may get you into a fight or flight mode, scientists tell us that it can release toxins into the heart, the lungs, the liver, and the kidneys. It's the heart that really matters though. Mess with that and sudden death could be on the way. We don't mean to scare you, by the way. You'd have to be really scared and possibly in bad health to drop dead from too much fear, but it does happen. We're told that adrenaline will release calcium into the heart. This might not be good because the consequence can be your heart not being able to slow down. This might cause something called ventricular fibrillation, which you could say is your heart beating like a pair of shoes in a clothes dryer. This might lead to blood not going to parts of your body and the possibility of you keeling over dead. Scientists say adrenaline-related deaths are not only because of fear, and people have died when playing sports or even making love. Again, this is very rare. Please don't give up playing basketball or practicing the dance of life anytime soon. Now let's take this a bit further and look at the first line of an article in the Scientific American in 2009. That was, a Charlotte, North Carolina man was charged with first-degree murder of a 79-year-old woman whom police say he's scared to death. The title of that story was, "Can a person be scared to death?" As we've said, the answer is yes, and in that case of the old woman, a man entered her house, gave her the fright of her life, and as we've just described, the rush of adrenaline gave her a heart attack and she died. The Scientific American interviewed the chairman of the neurology department at Brigham and Women's Hospital in Boston and asked him if a person could be scared to death, and he resoundingly answered, absolutely, no question about it. He talked about the big downside of what he called revving up your system. He went on to say what we've already told you, relating to the autonomic nervous system and adrenaline, adding that while this might produce liver or kidney failure, it's really only a matter of the heart when it comes to dropping down dead. And get this, he said people have been known to die when they had a huge rush of happiness. He said there was one case when a man playing golf got a hole in one and then said to his golf partner, "I can die now." And that's exactly what happened. He was so overwhelmed with the feeling that too much calcium rushed into his heart and the organ couldn't take it. In another interview, but this time with NPR, the same person talked about a man that bowled a perfect 300 and he said to his teammates, "I've finally done it," and then he dropped down dead. Sudden cardiac deaths have spiked when there are big sporting games on. You can just imagine the scene. Man gets up and punches the air while the ball is hit out of the park, man falls down dead. We found data on the Soccer World Cup in Germany and related sudden deaths. When it was held in that country, some Germans dropped down dead during Germany games. The research showed that there was 3 times the risk of sudden death during the days when Germany had a game. Even religious passion has felled some people, so be careful with that religious ecstasy. You can imagine another scene, this time a conversation. "How did he die?" Ecstasy. Rave? No, church. We said don't panic, but the Scientific American said, well, this has more chance of happening to someone with a pre-existing heart condition. It can actually happen to healthy people of any age. In an interview with the American Heart Foundation, a doctor backed up what the Scientific American said. He said, while very rare, anyone can be scared to death, even young folks, but for it to happen, you'd have to be really, really scared. Okay, now that you've heard that, we think we should try and find some cases of when young or middle-aged healthy people were literally frightened to death. We could find quite a few news stories of older folks being scared to death, but it seems it doesn't happen to younger people very often. We did find a BBC story about a drunken man in Scotland who decided to enter a store and start smashing it up. The man who owned the store, it was said, dropped down dead out of fear. He wasn't young, but he wasn't very old either. We should say that the man had problems with his heart in the past. The young man who had done the damage pled guilty to culpable homicide. Then there's the case of an LA earthquake that happened in 1994. That day, 24 people just dropped down dead after the quake. The average was pretty old at 68, but only 42% of the victims had pre-existing heart conditions. We looked all over the world and couldn't find news stories of young people being scared to death, but the scientists agree it could happen. Have you ever been so frightened you thought you might just die? Tell us in the comments. Now go watch how people literally laughed to death. Thanks for watching, and as always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next time.